And welcome back to the Crochet Crowd, as well as my friends over at Yarnspirations.com. I'm your host, Mikey. Today we're gonna work on this beautiful wrap. It's called the Openwork Wrap. It's kind of complicated, but it's kind of not. And today I'm gonna be able to show you the ins and outs of being able to do one of these wraps from start to finish. The pattern is free and fabulous, and if you go to the more information of this video, you'll find a link in order to access it. Now this worksheet that I'll be showing you today that has all of these fabulous stuff will be available only on thecrochetcrowd.com under the same name of the Open Work Wrap. I have taken the mystery out of this wrap in order to do some diagram work, so I worked really hard with Diva Dan and we created some different options for you in order for you to be able to pick up this pattern, so you'll be able to see everything here that I am playing with on camera. So today in order to work you need Karen Simply Soft yarn, only 3 balls, and the model is of course wearing black, and today I'm using a really cool green color, and you'll need a 5.5 millimeter size eye crochet hook in order to play. Without further ado, let's go to the crochet diagram first and let's take some of the mystery out so that you can play along with me today. So let's take a closer look on the construction of doing this particular wrap. You're gonna notice it's kind of weird, and I have to say just bear with me, just keep on playing. So what we have here is that we have actually 2 pieces and it's divided right down in the middle. So what's gonna happen is that we are going to create one side of the wrap and then go to the point, and then we're gonna come back on the same starting chain, create the other side and do the point on the other side. So this photo is showing it partially done. Now this is a kind of really interesting thing because this is open lace work and there's a lot of stuff going on. So if you look up here, I did some diagram work in handwriting so that Daniel could actually do the diagram. But what I want to show you is that this center piece is so important because what happens on one side kind of happens on the other, but in a different timing. So let's take a closer look here at the top, and here is the center point. I marked it with a stitch marker, and then what you see here is that you have one side that has been completed, and then we come back and do the other side just like so. It's quite fabulous, and you want to keep the pattern in sync with each other so that you don't see this stitch line very, very easily. You will see it slightly, but it is so small and so minor that you can keep it just looking quite fabulous. So why would they have designed it like this? Well, it's all about the model, right? So that it's draping down through the front of her body and straight down, but you want the stitches to be in the same direction. So if you just do this whole panel from start to finish, it'll be down on one side and it'll be up on the other. It won't be in balance. So by doing it in 2 sections like this, when she's wearing it one side to the other, the stitches will all be in balance, and then you won't have anybody saying to you, oh, it looks out of balance. You don't need to worry about it, and because of the way that it's done right here in the very beginning is that it's gonna be very difficult to see where you stopped and started. So let's take a closer look at the diagram. Let's really wow you with that next. So here's what the diagrams look like. There's a first half and a second half, and I'm gonna zoom in on both of these so that I can show you, but I wanna show you them from a distance first. There is a slight difference, and what happens is that we're gonna do the first half and we're gonna start our starting chain, and then we're going to just do row number 1, which is unique. Then rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5 are repeating over and over and over until we start doing the decrease in order to get to the point. So it's a really quite an easy thing, but it's so much easier to see it in diagram format than it is in the written instructions. So this is the other side here is the second half, and it looks slightly different. So the only difference is that the starting is different. So row number 2 on the top half looks different than row number 2 on the bottom half, and that's because the pattern is staying in sync so that you can look across the model's back and it looks pretty seamless. So it keeps it all nice and sync with each other, and it's really quite fabulous. So you need to complete so many rows of that as well. So you need to do rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then do that, and then do the point then to the end. Once we get to the end then there's a decrease, and so the decrease happens to be the same on both. And so what we're gonna do then is gonna start stepping in like a stepping stairways as we do a decrease, and then you're just gonna continue to repeat that until you get closer and closer until you get to the final 4 rows. And the final 4 rows are slightly different in order for you to have that perfect ending on your shawl. So let's take a closer look on number 1 of the first half of the diagram in order to do this shawl. So this is the first half of the diagram, and what happens is that we're gonna start off and we're gonna create the starting chain just like you see here, and we're gonna come back and we're gonna do some single crochets, we're gonna do double crochets together, and we're gonna start creating the foundation in order for rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5 in order to work up. You're going to notice that it is basically kind of very similar to each other, but each of rows number 2 and 4 has a different starting point so that these shell work, just like you see here, falls in a different spot in order to have the amazing look. And if you can remember that, it's a lot easier. But I have to say, these diagrams are really quite amazing in order for you to follow up. Here's the thing, okay? So if anything, you're gonna listen to me in today's video, you need to watch stitch marker at the end of row number 1. Okay, I'm gonna repeat that because that's so important. You need to put a stitch marker at the end of row number 1. And the reason for it is that at the end of row number 1, when we go to do the second half, that's where we wanna start. So I don't want you accidentally starting on the wrong side, because then that means that the peaking of doing your particular wrap, it won't be in balance with each other. So the peak will go in the wrong direction. So make sure you do mark that as you go. So what we're gonna do today is that we're going to go through the stitch work of doing the first half together, of getting you started, then doing rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5 and letting you repeat. After we get that done, we're then going to move to the other half. And what we're going to do is that this blue here of chaining, just like you see here, is actually the starting chain of the original up here. So you don't need to create that, it's already there. So right where the stitch marker, and I put a label right here on this diagram, that's where you're gonna start, and you're going to then create the look that you see. And so then you have to repeat number 2, 3, 4, and 5, and you have to repeat that 9 times. So I have those instructions as you see here. So you have to really kind of watch for that when you're going to do it. Now originally when I did this pattern is that I had the top done and I was kind of lazy and I said, okay, I have to do a repeating of rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5. The problem is that because you're staying in balance and it wants to be seamless on the other side, rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5 are different on the opposite side in order for it to stay in balance. So it's actually 4, 5, 2, 3. Trying to remember that in your head is kind of crazy. So what I did is I did a second diagram so that you can put this one away, not worry about it when you're doing the second half, and pull up the second one right here and be able to follow along. So you're just gonna do the number of repeats in order to get to the end of this project, and then you're gonna start doing the decreasing. Here's the thing. On the first half, you're going to do rows number 1 through 5, and then you're gonna do rows number 2 through 5 one more time. So it says that there's 1 on here, 1 through 5, it should say 2, I will correct that by the time you get access to that. And so it's gonna repeat 9 times, so you're gonna do all 4 rows 9 times. Then you're gonna do rows number 2 and 3 one more time in order for you to get in balance. Look at row number 3 here, okay? Do you see here? So when you do the second half, you're gonna repeat, do rows number 1 through 5, and then again, I'll correct this again, 2 through 5. And then what's gonna happen is that you're gonna finish. And you will notice that row number 5 here is the same as row number 3 up here. It's the same thing. So when you go to do the decrease on here, you don't need to pull out your hair because you're in the exact space that you need to be. So on this diagram, I wrote on here, this is row number 3 of the first half, row number 5 of the second half, it's the same one, and you will notice that you're gonna continue and start your decrease. So you don't have to think twice about the decreasing. Then eventually as you get near to the end, then you can just polish it off in the very final 4 rows just like you see. Now I know that was very long-winded, but this is a really kind of a complex pattern if you're not thinking about it too carefully. And my goal today is that you'll be successful in order to have one of these for yourself. So without further ado, let's grab a 5.5 millimeter size eye crochet hook today. Grab your Karen Simply Soft and let's get playing with this pattern. So let's move along to the first half today, and we're going to get you started. We're gonna start with a starting chain, and you need to do a total chain of 84, and then you're gonna come back across. Now you'll notice the sample here in the diagram is a smaller thing. Just think about it that it keeps on going and going and going. It's just a repeat pattern going across. We need to then do rows number 1 through 5 together, and then we're gonna do rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5 a total of 9 more times. So you're gonna do 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, keep doing that 9 times, and then you're gonna come back and do rows number 2 and 3 one more time in order to be balanced before starting the increase. So today's tutorial, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get you started on row number 1, and then I'm gonna take you through rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you can reverse back the video in order to then complete and do rows number 2, 3, 4, or 5 if you don't get it. And remember that the information that you're seeing on screen today is available in the more information link of today's video description so that you can access anything that I'm showing you today. So let's grab our 5.5 millimeter size eye crochet hook and Karen Simply Soft yarn, and let's play today. So leaving an extra long tail so you can use to sew that in later, let's create a slip knot. And this is an intermediate level open work shawl today, open work wrap. So you want to do a total of 84 for your starting. So just rotate and just pull it through. So just chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Go all the way to 84 for me and meet me back here in just a moment. So now that you got your chain down, we're now going to start row number 1. It's the only time this is ever gonna appear for row number 1. So this is the only time you're gonna see it like this. So row number 1, what we're gonna do is that we're gonna double crochet 5th chain from the hook, and then we're gonna chain 3, and then we're gonna skip a stitch, single crochet, and then create these arches of chaining of 5. Skip so many stitches as you see here, and then single crochet. So our whole idea is to get this pattern established right off the hop. So when we go to do then the second half, what's gonna happen is that we're gonna use that particular chain and do kind of the opposite on the other side in the exact same spaces. So it's gonna be a lot of fun in order to do this. So let's move along to row number 1. You can follow this on the diagram if you wish as well. So let's begin row number 1. So row number 1, we're gonna double crochet 5th chain of the hook. So let's look and count. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and I want you to double crochet 5th chain from the hook. Just like that. So this is actually gonna count in the instructions if you're looking at it carefully, is actually it's gonna be 2 double crochet together. It doesn't look that way, but that's what it counts as. So now you're going to chain a total of 3, and there's gonna be a consistency of chaining sub 3 and 5 throughout today's pattern. So let's chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and you wanna skip 1 chain and go to the second chain over and single crochet in to that chain, and then chain 3 once again. So 1, 2, 3, and then keep on going 4 and 5. So total chaining of 5, and I want you to skip a total of 3 chains. So 1, 2, 3, go to the fourth, and I want you to single crochet in. Now continuing along, you're gonna chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, you're gonna skip 1 chain, and you're gonna go to the second chain over, and you're gonna put 3 double crochet together. So how we do that is that we wrap the hook and going into the next stitch. So we skip 1 stitch, second chain over, and just come and pull through, and then pull through 2 and hold. You then keep moving along your chain. So wrap the hook, pull through, and you wanna do that a total of 3 times so that you end up with 4 loops on your hook, and then pull through all 4 loops. And those 3 in the chain just became 1. Do you see how they look like that? We're gonna be doing that throughout today's tutorial in different areas of today's pattern. So you're going to work, and you're now gonna continue along. So chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3. And the nice thing about this, when you see 3 together, you are always gonna know that you have to lead in with the chaining of 3 before it and 3 after. And if you can remember that, it makes it quicker for you to remember this pattern as well. So now that we got our chain 3, after we've done that, we skip 1 and go to the second one over, and we're single crocheting into that one. And so now we're gonna chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and I want you to skip 3 chains. So 1, 2, and 3, go to the fourth and single crochet in. And now chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and now we're gonna do that together thing all over again. So the pattern is repeating itself. So skip the first stitch, go to the second over, and put 3 double crochets together. So you're just gonna go into the next one, pull through and hold it, and then the next one, pull through, and then pull it through, and continue to gather them so that you have 3 together. So then pull through all 4 loops, and then you're gonna chain 3. So remember, before you let into that, you chain 3. After you get over that, chain 3. It's kind of how I remembered it when I was doing it. So I skip 1, and I go the second one over, and I single crochet, and then I chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, skip 3. So 1, 2, 3, go to the fourth, and remember, you're getting yourself established now. So it's you know, it's always harder to work from a chain, but once you can see this pattern materializing, it gets a lot easier. So chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, skip the next chain and put the next 3 together for another double crochet 3 together. And you keep doing that. So you just, no matter how big that your project is, so when you have your 84, you'll have a lot longer chain than me. It doesn't take that much longer, I have to tell you though. So chaining a 3. So 1, 2, 3, and then skip one chain, single crochet into the next. So for me, I'm getting close to the end of my chain, so you have some more time to work on it, so you can put me on pause. But when you get to the very end, here's what you're going to do, the end of your row. So now to finish off, you're gonna chain your 5 and you're going to single crochet, you're skipping 3 and then continuing along. And then to finish off this row, no matter how long that you made it, if you did it 84, if you're doing a small sample like me, you're still gonna chain your 3 and then you're just gonna skip 1 and the final 2 chains will be 2 together for double crochet. So this is row number 1 and you never have to do this again. Not like this. And so this just gets you established on being able to get your chain 5 spaces. You have your 3s together and now we're gonna move up to do rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5 and that's the actual repeat pattern and that's where you're gonna wanna come back to when you need to repeat. So let's move along to row number 2. So this is where you're going to start if you're gonna reverse the video back in order to follow me along if you need more help. So in order to do row number 2, no matter any time you're starting row number 2, in the first half it's always gonna be the same. It'll be chaining up 1 to begin and we're going to single crochet ourselves. You know what, I should show the diagram first. So in row number 2, we're going to start off and we're going to single crochet in the first one here, see the 2 together, and then we're going to then chain our 5s. And in the chain 5 spaces here, there's gonna be 5 double crochets. So anytime there's a chain 5 space, you'll notice that there's 5 double crochets that fit into it. Now this is a very easy row to figure out, okay? So this row, row number 2 and 4 is very easy because there's always gonna be chaining of 5 that separates things. So it's the only rows number 3 and 5 that you have to is worrying about doing chains of 3 and 5. So rows number 2 and 4 are actually quite simple. So it's chaining of 5, you put 5 double crochets, chaining of 5, 1 single into the top, and then chaining of 5 and so on. So you'll find that rows number 2 and 4 are quite easy. So let's move along to rows number 2. So let's move along to row number 2. We're gonna chain up 1 to begin and then single crochet right into the top of that first 2 together. So as I mentioned, we're going to chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you come all the way to the chain 5 space. So you're skipping over this one here and coming right into the middle right here. And you're gonna put in 5 double crochets into that space. So don't have to go into any chains at all. Just go around the space and put in 5 double crochets. So this is a very lacy wrap, so it actually really kind of works out good. You could just looking for gaps and spaces and it just becomes very easy that way. So once you have your 5, you're gonna chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, see how you got the 3 together? The top one of that where they come together right here, okay? So just look at really carefully where I'm pointing right here. You see the hole? That is the middle of that. So you're gonna single crochet into the middle of that and then you're gonna chain 5 and jump forward. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then you come in to the next chain 5 space. Okay, so skipping this, that's a chain 3. Go right to the here, it's the chain 5 and you're going to double crochet. And you're double crocheting 5 times. So just remember it's about 5. And if you can remember that, it just is easier to remember too. Okay, so once your 5 are in, chain 5. Okay, and then jump across. So now they're 3 together. Remember, it's gonna be right in the middle of where all 3 are put together and you're going to single crochet and then chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you're gonna continue to move across your entire row doing this exact same thing. So it's really not a hard pattern to be able to follow. So just look for the next chain 5 space. Okay, and you will be able to get it. And I want you to go all the way across your row and I'll see you at the end of this row in just a few moments. Okay, once you come to the end of the row, you're gonna run out of spaces. And so I have my 5 double crochets in and so I want to chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the 5th one that joining, okay, so normally it would have been where there's 3 together like you see here, but on the end there's only 2 together and you were just going to single crochet in the top of where it's 2 together and that completes it. So the way that I remembered it for myself when I was doing this is that I started this row here with a single crochet right at the very top and then I'm going to finish it with a single crochet. So just remember that. So let's turn our work and move up to row number 3. So in row number 3, we're going to chain up a total of 6 right here where we did the single crochet, and we're gonna chain up, and then we're gonna come back into the first chaining 5, and we're gonna put a single crochet, and then we are going to chain up 3 and then do the 3 together. So we had already done that 3 together here on the chain, but up here we're going to be working with the group of 5 and only selecting the middle 3 and then chaining a 3 and then just grabbing these chain spaces as you go. And so every time you are working before they come together is chaining a 3. You bring the 3 together, and then it's chaining a 3, and then the one section here in the middle has the 5 where the next 5 double crochets will sit into it in the row above it. So just think about where things are sitting in the pattern when you're being able to follow it along. So let's move along to row number 3. So let's move along to row number 3. So we're gonna be playing right into this big chain space that you see right here, and we're gonna get started. So let's chaining a total of 6. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Why do you think that it's chaining of 6? The answer is that on the other side, if you look very carefully and follow it all the way across on the paper, you'll notice that it's a treble. So this chaining is 6, 4 of those chains counts as a treble, and the other 2 counts as a chain 2 space. And so it just really kind of makes a lot of sense that when you're going to work on that. So let's move along, and we are going to then just come across, and we are going to then single crochet into this first chain space here, and then we're going to then come to this area. So we're gonna chain up 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and we're just gonna worry about these 5 that are in the middle and only select the 3 middle and put the 3 together for double crochet or double crochet together. So put those together and then chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and then come to the next chain space, single crochet around it, and then chain 5. So this will be where the 5 double crochets are gonna sit next time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then come to the next chain space and single crochet. And now look where the next 5 double crochets, that's right here. So in order to get there, you have to chain up 3 first. So 1, 2, and 3, and put the 3 middle double crochets together so that they come together as 1. See how easy that pattern is, right? So then chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, come to the next space, single crochet around it, and then chain 5. So this will be the next double crochet area here. And then single crochet around the next space, and then we're looking for the next 5 that you see. So chain 3 to get there first, and then put the middle 3 together. Okay, chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and then continuing along just like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so it's just a repeat pattern that you have going across, and then 1, 2, and 3, and then put the middle together. So you're eventually gonna get to the other side like I am. Obviously your panel is gonna be bigger than my sample here. And so to finish off this particular one, all we just need to do then is chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and you're going to come in and you're going to single crochet around that space first, then chain 2, and then treble around that space, or treble into the top of the first single crochet that you had before. So that's how you finish that. So that was row number 3. So let's move along, and we're going to move on to row number 4. Okay, so for those that are following along, you'll notice that I just scratched out a certain digit here. There was an error right here originally when I just started this particular line, but there's actually only 2 here to, in order to bring it in balance to the other side. So on your sample that you're gonna be able to download online, this will already be corrected. So now we're gonna move up to row number 4. We're gonna chain up 3 and then put 2 more double crochets into the middle here. So this is like the equivalent of half of one of these 5. Okay, so when we go to look at this, is just, you gotta just think about everything is just kind of shifting in order for these to be in balance with each other. So we're just gonna continue to move across. Now remember what I said is that rows 2 and 5 are pretty much the easiest. Everything is being separated by 5 chains as you're going all the way across. And then we're gonna finish off, and in row number, on the last section here, in this chain up here, in the 4th one, you're gonna put 3 double crochets into there to bring it balanced to what is happening on the other side. So let's move up to row number 4. So let's move up to row number 4. It's gonna be chaining a 3 counts as a double crochet, and then I want you to double crochet 2 more times into that same stitch right below. Okay, so it's in the, all into the same. So it appeared that there's three coming together into one stitch, which is what exactly what you're looking for. So now what we're going to do is that we are going to chain a total of five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and you jump all the way to where the three are sitting together, right into that middle spot right there, and you're going to single crochet in, and then you're gonna chain five. So it's all about chaining a five, right, in this particular one. So chain five, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now remember those spaces that we made with the chain fives in the row below? It's right here. Okay, so you got a space here, that's chain three, this is chain five. You wanna put five double crochets in the chain five space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Just like that. So then how many chains are you gonna do? If you said the answer is five, you're right. So it's all about five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then coming into the next section where the three are coming together, that's gonna be a single crochet. Then how many chains? I bet you're saying five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the right answer. And then come up to the next chain five space and put in five double crochets. Do you remember? See how easy that is? If you can just get a memory hook. So rows number 2 and 4 are very similar to each other. They just start off at a different spot so that they can align properly within today's wrap. So we're gonna do five double crochets and then chain five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're gonna go all the way across and you're gonna single crochet in the three together here. You're gonna go all the way across using the same technique. So let's get to the other side. I'm almost done here. So chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come to the next chain five space and put in five double crochets. Just like so. I'm on number 4 and 5. And then chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you're gonna come to the next where the three are together, put in another single crochet. So remember how we're gonna finish this row, and you can see it on the diagram as well. So you're gonna chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you're gonna stretch all the way. So you see this big long chain? Remember that was chaining a six? So go up to the fifth chain, so the fourth chain. So 1, just count it up. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I want you to put in a total of 3 double crochets. Okay, so that's how you conclude that row. So now you have balance within yourself, just like you see. Okay, so let's move up to row number 5, which is the final of the repeat pattern, and then you're gonna do rows number 2 through 5 over and over and over again for the first half. So row number 5, this is it. This is the final time, and then you're gonna go back to row number 2 again and go 2, 3, 4, 5. So in row number 5, what we're gonna do is that we're going to then do like the three together all over again, but it's in a different spot. So we're gonna chain up 3, and then we're going to double crochet into the next one. So the way that the chaining of 3 up works up, and this double crochet in the next one, it's like 2 together. So look on the other side, it's like 2 together. So just make sure that you kind of remember that in the back of your brain. You don't have to think about it too hard. And then you're gonna chain up 3, and you're gonna play within these gap spaces all over again. So you're creating these chain 5s again for the next time that you're gonna have that in the row above, and then you're gonna put your 3 together. So let's move along to row number 5. This is the first half. So let's turn our work and go for row number 5. So we're gonna chain up 3, so 1, 2, 3, and we're gonna double crochet into the next stitch. Okay, and this is counting technically as 2 together. Okay, so let's continue along. We're going to chain up 3, so 1, 2, and 3, and coming into this next chain space, okay, it's just right off there, you're gonna single crochet first, and then you want to jump over 5. Okay, so do you see how there's only 2 spaces here between these sections? So you're kind of creating 3 spaces for the next section. So you want to chain 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and single crochet in the next chain space. Chain 3. Okay, so the chain 3 was leading into on top of these, and there's gonna be 3 together as normal. Okay, so you already know what you're kind of doing with that, right? It's just in a different space. So before it was closer to the edge when you did it. This time it's a little bit further over, and then the next time when you go to repeat it again, it'll be closer to the edge all over again. So you're gonna chain three as you leave that, and you're gonna single crochet around the next chain space, jump over five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Go to the next chain space, single crochet, and now you're gonna lead into the three together again. So before you get there, chain three first, and then put the middle three double crochets together. Just like that. Chain three. So 1, 2, and 3. Coming into the next chain space, single crochet, jump over by chaining 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then coming into the next space, single crochet, chain up 3, and then put the next 3 double crochets together. Like the middle 3. It'll always be the middle 3 double crochets that you do that with. And then chain 3. As you lead out of there, go and single crochet around the next space, and now you're just gonna keep repeating that until you get to the other side. And then on the other side, you're gonna chain up 5 as you continue to follow the pattern across. And then the very final section, just like you see here, you're gonna chain up 3. So 1, 2, and 3. And the final 2 double crochets that are in the edge, you wanna put those 2 together. Just like that. And that's it. So that's row number 5. So I've taught you now how to do rows number 2 through 5. So all it's gonna do now is in the next section here, when you go through 2 through 5 again, this is gonna appear right in the section right here, right in front, and then these will appear again and again, and it will just keep on going. So you need to repeat rows number 2 through 5 9 more times. That's right, do 9 more times. And then I need you to repeat rows number 2 and 3 just one more time. And you wanna finish off, finishing off on row number 3 to keep this in balance. And then you're gonna move along to doing the decreasing in order to get it to squash in. So what I'm gonna do in today's tutorial is that I'm gonna show you how to start the second half next, and then I'm gonna show you the how to do the decrease after that. So without further ado, let's move along to the second half where I show you what to do in order to start properly. Before you move along to do the second half, and before you go any further, what I want you to do is just grab a spare piece of yarn and see where this tail is hanging off right here. I want you to put a stitch marker right in that spot so you remember where you need to start when you do the second half. Okay, so you're gonna put that there, and now you're gonna continue then to finish off the first half. So just make sure you put that there so that you don't accidentally start on the wrong side of your project. So without further ado, let's move on to the second half now. So up until this point in the tutorial, you've been following the first half of the diagram, and now you are going to, you're gonna be doing the decrease first, and then you'll start the second side. But in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you the second side first before the decrease, because the decrease is the same for both. So in the second part of it here, we need to do the second half, and the starting chain is already existing what you have. So you wanna turn your project upside down, and you want to start your stitch marker right where it was. So I had you put a stitch marker in, and so that's where you're gonna start, where the stitch marker is labeled on the project. And that's where we're gonna start here, and then we're gonna continue along. So we need to start this very first section over here. It's not a hard thing to do, and then we're gonna go then through rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5, and I'm telling you it's the same thing as what you just did. The only difference is that the order is slightly different so that the pattern stays in balance with each other. So let's move along to row number 1, starting second side. So let's start the second side, and I have my stitch marker in, and that's exactly where I wanna start. Just as a disclaimer here is that I don't have enough yarn to in order to do a sample and finish my project, so I'm just going to leave a tail on. It's still attached to the sample, but I am gonna frog it at the end of this so that I can finish off my shawl and throw it in the charity bin. So right where I have it right in the end here is that that's where I want to start my first stitch, and I'm just gonna go in and just attach with a slip stitch. Okay, so slip stitch it first, and then I want you to chain a total of 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So if you remember from the first side, that counts as a treble plus chain 2. So now you're just going to skip over, and what I want you to pay attention to is where everything is attached in the rows below. Okay, so it's upside down, and so the stitch work that you have been working with is upside down. So what I want you to do is that I want you to go to where this stitch is right here, okay, and I want you to go into that same stitch and I want you to single crochet. So you're matching everything. So this is what keeps it looking very consistent on the back when you're wearing it. So now you're gonna chain up three. So 1, 2, and 3. And now you're going to go in the specific chains itself. So don't go around the space because then it will decrease on itself and it won't look good. But you wanna go into the three chains and you're gonna do three together double crochets using that chain work. So you've kind of already done that before, right? So you should be able to do that again and then pull all together and then chain three. So 1, 2, and 3. And you come to the very next stitch just like you see here. Okay, see how it's attached on the other side? So that's where you're going to go. So you're watching everything. So everything's gonna match and stay open with each other to keep it in balance. So now you're going to chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're gonna skip all over this and just jump over to this next space. So skip over these three togethers area and just go to the next space right over here. Seems like such a long jump, but it works out and it's fabulous. So now you're gonna chain three, 1, 2, 3, and now you're gonna put the next three chains together. So just see how it's the five double crochets are right underneath it. So whenever you see that, the ones will be the three together in this section. Okay, then chain three and then single crochet together, or sorry, single crochet in the next space right there. So right into the next actual stitch and then chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Jump all over everything here and then single crochet into this next section. So you're just getting yourself established. So 1, 2, and 3. I can see the five double crochets are upside down, so I know I'm in the right spot, and so the next three chains will be to come together for double crochets. Okay, and then chain three. So 1, 2, and 3, and then coming in to the next stitch and single crochet and then chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you're gonna do that all the way across your bottom end here and single crochet in the next space, and eventually you'll get to the other side like I will. So chain up 3, 1, 2, and 3, and then just put the next three together for double crochets. Okay, and then chain three. So 1, 2, 3, and then single into the next. And now to finish it off on the other side, you're going to chain two, and then you're going to put in a treble here right on the other side right here. Okay, right in the top. So one, so wrap the hook twice and do a treble. Just like you see there. Okay, so now you've just gone all the way across. You've now got yourself established. So that was row number one of the second side. Now let's go back and let's review row number two of the second side. Let's turn our work first and then I'll show you what it looks like on the diagram. So here's what it looks like on the diagram. So now we're just gonna do rows number 2, 3, 4, and 5. It's exactly what you already know that was done before. It's just in a different order so that it stays in balance. So we're gonna chain up three immediately, put two into the first one, then chain five, and then you can see it's just balancing across like you had already done before. So I don't need to go through this as extensively as I did in the first half because it's exactly what you're already doing. It's just in a different order. So let's move along to row number two. So let's move on to row number two. We're gonna chain up three. So 1, 2, and 3, and then double crochet two more times into the same stitch. So if you can read diagrams, this is an easy pattern to be able to follow if you can do that. And then you're gonna chain up three, chain up five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then just come and just right where the three are together, you're just gonna go into the single crochet right where they come together and then go for another five. So this is one of those easy rounds or easy rows of just the fives if you remember from before. So just remember like you had before, the next chain five space is gonna get five double crochets. So hopefully by the time you've hit this part of the tutorial and you're working on your sample, you see how all of this makes sense and all of it comes together beautifully. Then once you get your five in, chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then come to the next where the three come together, single crochet there first, and then chain five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the next chain five space. You wanna put in five double crochets. chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then coming into the next 3 together, single crochet, then chain 5, and you do this all the way across your chain, or all the way across your row as you normally have been doing. The next one is 5 double crochets in there. So what do you think is the difference between the decrease rows and these rows that you see? The only difference is that you stop a little earlier each and every time in order to create the point. So chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then just single crochet in the top of the 3 together, and then 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you just come immediately into the very first one way over here, okay, and you are gonna immediately just put in into the third stitch up, you're gonna put in 3 double crochets up, or 3 double crochets into there, and that creates like a half of those group of 5 double crochets. So this was row number 2, and you can see everything is coming together quite nicely, and let's move along to row number 3. So let's turn our work first, and let's pull up our chart once again. So here we go back on the chart that you see here in row number 3. So we're gonna immediately chain up 3 and put a double crochet in the next one. So that's gonna be considered like 2 together. You see that on both sides, and you already know what you're doing with here with the 3 together and so forth. So we're gonna create those chain 5 spaces in order to do the 5 double crochets again. So let's move up to row number 3. So in row number 3, you're gonna chain up 3, 1, 2, and 3, and double crochet into the next one. So that's counting as a 2 double crochets together. It's not technically, but that's what they're saying that it is. And then you're gonna chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and then you're just gonna single crochet around the next space, and then you are going to chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then single crochet around the next space, and then chain 3. So the next one here is the 5 double crochets. So it's gonna put 3 of those together. So in order to get there first, we have to chain 3 first, and put the middle 3 together, just like you see, and then chain 3. So 1, 2, 3, single crochet in the next, and then chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, single crochet in the next. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, the next 3 are coming together, and you do that all the way across then for row number 3. So I'll meet you at the end of this row, and I'll just show you quickly how to finish off. So as you come to the end of the row in number 3, you're going to chain 3 first, and then you're gonna put the last 2 double crochets together with 2 double crochet together, and that will complete off row number 3. So let's turn our work, and let's pull back that chart, and let's go for row number 4. So in row number 4, what we have is that we're gonna start off with the single crochet first. So chain up 1 single crochet, and then it's the groups of 5 all over again. Let's begin row number 4. So row number 4, you already know how to do. You're gonna chain up 1 first, and then single crochet, and then you're gonna chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you're just gonna skip over to this chain 5 space and put in 5 double crochets. Okay, and we're continuing along, and then chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then just go into the top of the 3 double crochets that are together. And I want you to continue that same idea going all the way across. So chain 5, then you put 5 double crochets in the chain 5 space here, and then so on. So continue along with row number 4. To finish up row number 4, all you have to just do is once you get your group of 5 double crochets and chain 5, all you're just gonna do then is single crochet in the top of the first one that you see. Okay, so just remember that you started it off with a single crochet on this side, you will finish it off. So let's turn our work, go for row number 5 together, and this will be the end of the repeat pattern then for second half, and then you'll keep repeating. So let's move along to row number 5. So in row number 5, all we're just gonna do is like before, we're gonna chain up 6, and then you're just gonna come across, and then you're just gonna be doing your three together as you normally have, leading your chain five spaces in one all over again in order to do that. So in the second half, we're gonna be doing a repeat rows now of 2, 3, 4, and 5 eventually after we get this done, and you wanna do that a total of 9 times. So let's just review on how to do row number 5. So let's begin row number 5. You're gonna chain up 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Do you remember what that counts as? A treble and chain 2. So don't forget that. So in the first chain space here, you're going to single crochet, and then you're gonna put the 3 middles here first. But remember, to get there, you gotta chain 3 first, and then put the middle 3 together. With a single, or 3 together, double crochet, 3 DC together, and then just chain 3. Then come to the next space, single crochet, and now you're gonna jump over by chaining 5. So you're creating that middle space again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then coming in, single crochet, chain 3 as it leads into the next group that you need to put together. So the 3 middles come together all over again. So I want you to repeat this all the way for number 5, and I'll see you at the end of this row. So let's finish off row number 5 together, and I've just done my 3 together. Let's chain up 3, 1, 2, and 3, going into the space, and then I'm chaining a total of 2, 1, and 2, and then I'm gonna treble into the first single crochet. So that's how you finish off row number 5. So in the second half, what you have to do is that you have to go back, and you can reverse this video and do rows number 2 through 5 all over again, a total of 9 times. And then you're ready to do the decrease. So on the first half, what we did is that we did 9 times, plus we had to do rows number 2 and 3 to, in order to get balance. This side only, you just do 9 times and then you're ready to go. So what I'm gonna do for you at this point is that I'm gonna show you how to decrease on paper itself, because the reality is that this pattern is so easy to follow if you're following it along in the diagram, that I'm gonna show you how to do it, and then I'll show you how to do the final decrease at the end where you can finish everything off nicely. So everything that you see that you're doing here is gonna happen on the decrease. The only difference is that you're gonna start eliminating stitches in order to get the point. And the point is more like flat up and coming on an angle like this. So let's pull up the decreasing to the point. Let's begin to do that next. So let's begin moving on to the decreasing of the point. So at this point, it doesn't matter if you're on the first half or second half. If you follow the set of instructions, then you will be in the exact same spot, and you do not fasten off your yarn in order to complete doing the decreasing. So you're just gonna pick up and do it. So what I've done here on the sheet is that I said this is row number 3 of the first half, and this is row number 5 of the second half. Either way, it's the same row. And so then the repeat pattern for the row is row number 1, 2, 3, and 4. But watch it, look what happens. You're just gonna come along, okay? And so we're gonna start row number 3 and 5. It's gonna come across, and we're gonna start row number 1 here. But look where it finishes. See where the 3 together are on the top? That's where it ends. That's the one right before the end. Okay, and so when you start on row number 2, you're gonna chain up 3, single crochet into that chain 5, and then you're gonna continue the pattern all the way back to the start again. Then in row number 3, you come all the way back across, look where you finish again. It's right on top of the 3 together. So you just have to keep an eye on that, because that's the easiest way to be able to tell with this pattern as where things finish. Then you just chain up a total of 5 that time, and then you just go into this chain space here, and then you do the 3 together. And you continually do that over and over. So in this particular section here is that the decreasing, you're gonna do rows number 1, 2, 3, and 4, and do that a total of 5 more times in order to do that. And what this will do is that it will give you to row number 24. And then in row number 24, I'm gonna show you how to do the final decrease, because it's slightly different than what you've been doing here. But at the end of row number 24, this is where you should be. Okay, you should be at here, and then we're gonna start chaining number 25 together. So everything that you already know in today's tutorial is already on here. The only difference is that you're ending earlier. So even though you can see the decrease happening, you just have to think about this, your pattern's much bigger than what you see on the sheet. And so every time you're coming back in this direction, you're kind of stopping right where the three come together. So I'm gonna leave that for you. It's kind of your homework. You know, part of learning how to crochet is learning how to read these diagrams, and I wanna leave that in your hands. And I know that most of you will be successful if you give yourself the time to be able to learn. And I think if you can learn stuff like this, any kind of patterns that I may throw at you in the future that have these kind of things, you may be actually quite surprised in yourself on how you skill build. And I think this is a great opportunity. So begin reducing your to the point, and then you can start the second side, and then to do the second side to do that. And if you're at this particular point in the tutorial where you're ready to go, then just continue along. So it's a really quite an easy pattern to be able to follow along generally, and I think that you'll have a lot of success. So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna meet you up at the final as we do the final decrease together, rows number 25 to 28, and then just make sure that you are watching where you're ending up early in order to create the point. So let's conclude our open work wrap, and we're going to conclude now with rows number 25, 26, 27, and 28, and you're gonna see that we're now gonna create this final look. Now the reason why this is different from the other decrease is that it changes just slightly here in the front end, but once we finish off row number 28 together, you're gonna be completely done. So if you've done your first half and this is part of your first half, then you are gonna wanna go back and do the second half and then come back and do this when you get back to the second half. So the decreasing on both sides is the same regardless of what side you're working on, obviously. So let's move along to rows number 25, 26, 27, and 28. So let's start on row number 25. We're going to chain up three as normal. That counts as a double crochet, and into the top of that same stitch you're going to put in two more double crochets. You already know what you're doing at this point. You're just going through the motions in order to get this done. You're then going to chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then coming down on the top where the three are coming together, you're gonna single crochet as you normally have been all throughout today's tutorial. You're going to now chain five. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then coming in, and this next big space as you have been all along is that there will be 5 double crochets as normal. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you're going to chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you're just gonna come into the top of this last one over here where the three are together. That's all there is for this. So you can see that you're running out of stitches a lot quicker now. It's gonna get done and you're gonna be able to wear this in no time. Let's turn our work and move up to row number 26 together. So 26, we're gonna chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and coming into this chain 5 space as you see, just go around the space and single crochet and then chain 3. 1, 2, and 3, and now the next group of 5, they're gonna come together as you have been all throughout today's tutorial, and you're gonna put 3 double crochets together just like that, and then chaining 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and then come to this next space, chain or single crochet around that next space, and then you're gonna jump into the next space like you have been all throughout today's tutorial. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You're gonna get tired of counting at 5. I'm sure you're glad it's gonna be almost done, and now you're gonna chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3, and like you had been doing all along in today's tutorial, the last two will be 2 together. So that was row number 26. So put those last 2 together and finish that off. Let's turn our work and move up to 27. We just got 2 more rows left and then you're free to wear this afghan or wear this shawl, and you're gonna chain up 1 and you're gonna single crochet into the first stitch and then chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then come into that big space right here in the center and you're going to put in 5 more double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you're gonna polish that off with the chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you're gonna come into the last one here where the three are together and just single crochet. Okay, you're on your final row right now, and this is row number 28, and let's get this started. So we're gonna chain up 3, single crochet in the first chain 5 space, and then chain up 3, 1, 2, 3, and then you're going to then put your 3 together in the next group of 5 double crochets again. just like that, and then chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, single crochet into the next chain space, and then finally let's finish this off. We're gonna chain 3, so 1, 2, and 3, and you are going to then put a treble in the final, and that's it. That's how you do this peak into the end. So now you just have to weave in your ends. Now if this is side number 1 for you, you have to go back and do the other side, and then you'll have to come back to this part of the video in order to finish it off, and it's gonna be quite fine and fabulous. So make sure you weave in your ends. So just cut your yarn. The best way to do it is just cut your yarn and just pull through, and I recommend this anyway because you're gonna be having this flail around and you know, catch the wind and stuff. So you're going to want to put it into a darning needle really quite easily. Don't be scared, and just run it through your project 3 times. So if you go in one direction, just in the stitch work, you don't want to impede with it, you know, pull through once, okay, don't over pull on it. Go the other direction twice, and then come back in the other direction for 3 times, and your project can never stretch in 3 directions at one time. So this is the best way to hide in these loose ends. Then you can trim it right down to the project just like so. So this is how you complete the open work wrap by Yarnspirations.com, and you can see it went to a beautiful point just right here at the end. The model's photo looks amazing as well. I'm excited about this as well, and I think that you are going to look fabulous when wearing this as well. So until next time, I'm Mikey on behalf of the Crochet Crowd as well as my friends over at Yarnspirations.com. Stay tuned next time as we have more free patterns and ideas coming ahead. Until next time, see ya.